On that one, that'll be our mistakes section done. Right.
Right.
No, we've talked about it before.
But haven't
you got somewhere to be?
I do, actually. My song is by Leonard Cohen, and it is called The Future. And it was released, so whatever, this was written a few years ago. So, we don't change that. But as ever with Leonard Cohen, the lyrics are important, so listen to them.
It's a homework for you all to listen to the lyrics
listen
of this song.
To the lyrics.
Be sure
the band's
to take
good
notes.
As well. The lyrics good as the band's good as well. Right. Okay, can we
is
hear
this by
Leonard Cohen?
Who's he?
Right. Let's go.
Secret life, it's lonely here, there's no one left to torture. Give me absolute control over every living soul, and lie beside me, baby, that's an order. Give me crack and careless sex, take the only tree that's left in. Suffer up the hole in your culture. Give me back the Berlin Wall, give me Stalin and St. Paul. I've seen the future, brother, it is murder. Things are gonna slide
in all directions.
Won't be nothing you can measure anymore. The blizzard of the world has crossed the threshold, and it's overturned the order of the soul. When they said, repent, I wonder what they meant. When they said, repent, I wonder what they meant. When they said, repent. Did I'm the little Jew who wrote the Bible. I've seen the nations rise and fall, heard their stories, heard them all, but love's the only engine of survival. Your servant here, he has been told to say it clear, to say it cold. It's over, it ain't going any further. And now the wheels of heaven stop, you feel the devil's riding crop. Get ready for the future, it is murder. Things are gonna slide
in all directions.
Won't be nothing you can measure anymore. The blizzard of the world has crossed the threshold, and it's overturned the order of the soul. When they said, repent, I wonder what they meant. When they said, repent, I wonder what they meant. When they said, repent. There'll be the breaking Western cold. Your private life will suddenly explode. There'll be phantoms, there'll be fires on the road, and a white man dancing. You'll see your woman hanging upside down, her features covered by her fallen gown, and all your lousy little poets coming around trying to sound like Charlie Manson. Yeah, the white girl's dancing. Give me back the Berlin Wall. Give me Stalin and St. Paul. Give me Christ, or give me Hiroshima. Destroying the fetus now. We don't like children anyhow. I've seen the future, baby. It is better. Thing gonna slide.
Slide in our direction.
Won't be nothing, won't be nothing. You can't measure anymore. The blizzard, the blizzard of the world has crossed the threshold, and it's overturned the border of the soul. When they say,
they say,
repent,
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 I wonder what they mean. When they say,
they say,
repent,
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 repent. I wonder what they meant when they said, repent,
repent,
repent. Very good.
I got some biblical overtones.
Reminded me of Dr. Faustus by Christopher Marlowe.
I was going to say at the start it sounded like a Disney villain song.
It sounded dead theatrical.
I loved it.
I thought it was good.
The music was incredible as well.
Yeah.
See, because you said that at the start. It helped because I've really focused on the lyrics and I probably wouldn't have done that otherwise.
I liked the keyboard and he started like singing like just before I then wrote he like talked about Hellfire as I wrote the word Sinister, and then the song pretty much went off from there.
Yeah. It's like a dystopian future.
Well, like
I think,
what does it mean? As he, I mean, he says that I'm the little Jew that wrote the Bible, right?
Oh.
I don't know my Bible history. Who wrote the Bible? Is it Jesus? No, I don't know.
Or is he saying that he's a prophet? Is that what it is?
Like, is... Yeah.
I don't know.
Well,
because if someone wrote the Bible, they would have... Nah, maybe not actually. I don't know.
I thought he was
just
yeah,
in case.
Right down the time and
you know you know at the start, right? That it took me. It took in the same way that Michael wrote something, and then it's sort of like, oh, that's the exact thing he wrote.
Yeah.
I started writing. This would be how like really hardcore Christians think. Anyone who doesn't believe in God would think.
Right.
But then as soon as I said that, it was like, I talked about the Bible and I was like, alright, okay.
It was the, destroy another fetus was a lyric that stood out as well.
Yeah.
We don't like children anyway or something. I've got the lyrics.
I feel like this is the kind of thing that I need to read, because I was trying to listen to the lyrics and think about what they mean, but it feels like it's doing like a higher English essay in real time. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
He says this and he means...
Genuine.
Like, Well, shite then, see, when shite he says,
they told me, repent, repent. That's like in Dr. Faustus, the play. High English.
Yeah.
He gets asked in his final hour to repent for his sins or whatever, and he doesn't do it. And he's like,
what happens to him?
Well, now you're gonna die.
Yeah,
he dies.
Yeah, I don't really. What do you think about it, Swanee? Because I don't. I feel like it's the kind of thing that would take a couple of lessons to really get a good idea
of. Yeah, that's true.
A couple of reads of the lyrics.
I think he's kind of satirizing the paranoia about us going into an Orwellian future.
Ooh.
But also, I think that he's fully aware that that's the way we're going.
Ah, right.
So
he's saying, this is the truth, but I'm also laughing at the fact you're scared of it. Bring it on.
I think like there's always a level of irony with Leonard Cohen stuff.
Right, fair.
There's always, because he is Jewish, there's always like that, and like not just like Jewish, but like that's how he identifies as, like he's a Jewish person. He's like, actually, he was raised as a Jew.
Practicing, yeah.
And then became a Buddhist monk later on in life, and that, very very spiritual guy. Aye, like Leonard Cohen is, like, if he wasn't a musician, his life would be as interesting as like a Hunter S. Thompson, or you know, like the same parallels can be drawn between him and any like the great writers of like Hemingway, like as a writer himself, out with music.
Yeah,
like, still
that's
there.
Crazy.
But I think it's just him kind of satirizing the age in which that song was like written in, so like I think it's like
92.
I was going to say late 80s, early 90s.
I did see 92, don't know if it's true, but I seen that when
I feel like it's like 80s. I feel like it's in the 80s when he wrote that.
1992, but
and aye,
when
like
it was released,
whatever,
when it was released.
Aye, like that kind just
fact check,
as
you're wrong.
Just as like computers and like telephones and like the kind of new media age is like coming into fruition, he's like kind of
everyone was so paranoid about all that stuff.
Everyone's always paranoid when new shit.
That's true. That's true.
Yeah. I don't know. I always think it's just him being a wee bit satirical.
Do you think the satire comes from less the lyrics and more the delivery? Like the sort of Dracula-esque voice.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
Is that not
like
just
that
to drive home his point though? You know, like you could say it's a kind of way you have to like match the content to the, I don't know, the setting, almost.
Aye, I suppose you can't sing that.
I mean,
you
could sing a bit like the Smiths have happy music and quite somber lyrics, but I feel like to really drive home his point, it just aids to like make your mind wander to that kind of area in the first place, I guess.
Or like Sympathy for the Devil.
Aye.
Rolling Stones. Say like some similar themes, just just
and
biblically
as well. There was Who Killed the Kennedys, and then he talks about, well, he doesn't talk about it explicitly, but when I looked up the lyrics, I couldn't help but spoil myself. It was like something about how the Clintons were into power, and he was talking about them.
Yeah, but it's like that
murderers or something like that.
That's same kind of like themes, but that song like gets you going. That song gets you pumped, and you're just going woo woo.
Yeah.
But that song's more like somber and sinister.
You know,
and
that song.
Whoa.
It's
whoa,
like
whoa.
I really like when lyrics make me go. like just
exhale through the nose slightly
aye,
faster.
I can't what you're saying. Like,
oh,
I get
Leonard,
what you're getting at,
you sly fox.
Aye, no, but I don't necessarily listen to music like that all the time, but
I like that way of describing it, because lyrics don't really they give you some reaction, but most of the time it's just internal. But when it's so like strong, it's like this the slightest exterior physical outcome of your inner
emotions. And that's a song that I've listened to like for like 15 years. but it's like only when you get like a wee bit older or like a wee bit more like cynical yourself that you start to pick up on the actual lyric content. Like, so see like that, discard the fetus now, we don't like children anyhow, but
yeah.
It's like see when I like heard that after not listening to that song for like 4 or 5 years, I was like, fucking hell. Like, Jesus. Anyway.
It's amazing that you could talk about stuff like that in music and still be like...
Yeah, the lyric of the second, second verse, give me crack and anal sex.
Yeah.
Like, nice.
Yeah. So, that dates it then. So, like, the crack epidemic is, like, what? Late 80s, early 90s, isn't it?
Yeah, it was after the LSD explosion in the 70s.
Yeah.
That was fucking hippies.
So that's my song.
So
nice.
Yeah. I've been liking your song, Swanee.